Hi, everyone, and welcome to another short and sweet video brought to you by Chartmetric. Today, we're going to have a look at how to compare three artists using our artist comparison report. So here's how you get there. After arriving on your Chartmetric dashboard, all you have to do is hover to the Compare tab here and select Artist Comparison Report. This will bring you to a page that allows you to search and compare up to three artists. So as you can see, immediately upon selecting artists, reports are generated detailing their performance across social and streaming platforms. So in this example, we're comparing Beyoncé to Drake to The Weeknd, and immediately you see high-level metrics comparing the artists to each other. So first we have their Chartmetric score, which is basically a scoring system comparing artists to themselves over time. And then we have their artist rank, fan base rank, and engagement ranks. These are other internal scoring systems we've developed that explain their, you know, fan base rank, for example, is measuring follower and subscriber data across platforms. Their engagement rank is measuring engagement metrics such as Spotify monthly listeners, likes on TikTok and Instagram, all to give you a rough idea of how these artists are doing accumulatively across platforms. And you obviously have the easy visual of seeing them alongside each other to compare. Then you have a graph showing their recent career momentum, whether they're experiencing a decline or growth in momentum across platforms. And keep in mind, these can change drastically over time depending on their content release schedule, whether or not they just put out a new album. After that, we have the audience section. And this immediately shows you high-level metrics for all of the platforms that we ingest. So this has to do with TikTok followers, Spotify listeners, YouTube views and subscribers, things like that. And then you're immediately able to see within certain parameters whose audience is the largest. So as we can see, Beyoncé has the largest audience with 441 million fans, whereas Drake only has 300 million fans and The Weeknd has 214. So they all seem to be doing okay, but Beyoncé seems to be the most popular based on fan base metrics that we're able to get across platforms. After that, we have top five countries for each of the artists, and then some high-level audience demographics having to do with their audience's gender and age. So this would come in handy, let's say, if you're a manager representing Beyoncé and you're booking a tour and you're deciding whether to bring along Drake or The Weeknd. You can see which of these artists have audiences who are similar to the artist that you're representing. Furthermore, we have Spotify metrics. As we know, Spotify is a huge indicator for an artist's popularity amongst music listeners. And as we can see, The Weeknd actually has the strongest metrics here, having almost 111 million monthly listeners on Spotify. But Drake and Beyoncé are doing okay as well, with 71 million and 51 million monthly listeners. You also see top tracks from each of the artists. Now, this is useful, let's say, if Beyoncé had done a collaboration with Drake and you want to see whether that collaboration appears in the top tracks for each of them on Spotify. And that would allow you to infer which of these artists is really pulling their weight in terms of helping lift the other artist up and create a track that may or may not be one of their most popular tracks overall. Beyond that, we have TikTok metrics. As we know, TikTok is a huge tastemaker for artists and songs these days, so we wanted to include that. We have followers, likes, views, and comments on TikTok for you to compare. Same goes for YouTube and even AirPlay metrics. We ingest AirPlay data both from terrestrial radio stations and SiriusXM, and you're able to see notable data here. And then finally, we have a fans also like section, which is similar to the fans also like section that you might see on Spotify. And this just shows you artists with audiences who are similar to the artists that you're focusing on. And this could be useful, like I said, for essentially benchmarking yourself against the competition and just learning more about the space in which you operate. So overall, the artist comparison tool is very useful for artists themselves if you want to compare yourself to the competition or benchmark yourself against someone who you aspire to perform at the same level at. And you'll get key insight into what it takes to perform at a certain level across both music and social platforms. So, hope you enjoyed this video, and please take advantage of our artist comparison report. Thank you.